to dance with my father again.
Hello, Christ Temple children and youth. Welcome to our special Father's Day service. My name is Richard Adote with the Children's Church.
My name is Michael Adote. I'm with the youth aged 12 to 14 years.
We are happy to have you here with us. We miss you so much. Just know that we have you in mind always. Let's pray and start today's service. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for our lives. We commit ourselves into your hands. Open our hearts and our minds to receive your word and be doers of your word. Amen.
Amen. Today is a very, very special day because we are celebrating fathers all over the world. Richard, let's test our knowledge of some Bible characters who we can call father figures. Are you ready?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. In Genesis chapter 17, verse 5, God made him a father of many nations. Who is he?
Abraham.
Wonderful. In Matthew chapter 2, verse 13 to 14, an angel appeared to him in a dream, asking him to take the young child, his mother, and flee to Egypt and stay there. Who was this?
Joseph.
Is it Joseph, the son of Jacob?
No, it's Joseph, the husband of Mary.
Great, Richard. To our third question. In 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 20 to 40, we read of a man who defeated 450 prophets of Baal on Mount Carmel. Who was this man?
Elijah the Tishbite.
Great. And finally, the Bible describes him as an evangelist. He went to the city of Samaria, preached Christ to them. In Acts chapter 8, verse 6, the Bible says that the multitudes with one accord heeded things spoken by him. Who was this? Apostle.
Philip.
Wonderful, Richard. So the important question that I have in mind is this. What comes to mind when we think of a father? Who is a father, Richard?
A father is the head of the home. He is responsible to making sure the entire home is serving God. Joshua chapter 25 verse 15 says, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." A father is one who instructs and disciplines in the Lord. A father is also one who shows compassion for his children. In Proverbs chapter 4, verse 11 to 12, we learn that our fathers are also a guide for life. And in 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 8, we also learn that the father is responsible for providing for the household. So these are some of the things that come to mind when we talk about fathers.
In Ephesians chapter 2, chapter 6, verse 2, the Bible instructs us to honor our fathers. I think there are three main ways we can do that. The first is listening to our fathers. When I say listen, I'm not referring to just hearing the things they tell us. We must try to understand the things our fathers tell us. We need to do that as a first step. Ephesians 6 verse 1 tells us to obey our fathers. That leads me to my second point, is to obey. When you've understood what your father tells you, obey the instruction. Follow through. Do what he has asked you to do. No matter how big or small it is, follow through on it. And finally, let's make our fathers proud by being wise and righteous. In Proverbs 23, verse 24, the Bible says, "A father whose child is wise and righteous is glad." That is surely the way we can make our fathers glad. Richard, I hear you have some activity for us with the kids. We have a special card for Dr. Otterville and the fathers of ICGC Christ Temple. I look forward to seeing the surprise we have.
Yes, we have a very good surprise for our fathers today. So it's our activity time, and I have here with me Natalie and Jaden. They are going to be helping me make a special Father's Day card to celebrate all fathers today. So we need some paper, some other kind of cutout paper, some colored pens, glue stick, and scissors to cut out what we are going to do. So, Jaden, are you ready? Natalie, are you ready? Let's go. Pattern out rectangles for me. And Jaden, you cut out any shape you can cut. Okay, so this is your scissors. You have the yellow. Natalie, you have the blue.
So cut out shapes for me while I fold the cards, okay?
I'd play a song that would never, ever end. How I'd love, love to dance with my father again.
Now we're going to stick it onto our card.
To get my way, I would run from her to him. He make me
look
just to come.
We have a lovely card with a shirt right in the middle.
Just what my
fathers always
said,
wear shirts, don't they?
Later that night,
okay. Okay, so this is our special Happy Father's Day card, and I'm going to read some of the messages Jaden and Natalie and some other children have sent across to us. One says, thank you for your care and love. I love you, Daddy. One also reads, you mean so much to me. One says, my daddy is great. I love you, Daddy. You are the best.
To dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside her door, and I'd hear how my mama cried for him.
Natalie, Jaden, let's all say Happy Father's Day.
Michael, how did you find our card?
That was lovely. I like the fact that it was a card that you could see was made for men, with the image of a man's shirt at the front and the wonderful messages from the children. I'm sure our fathers will be beaming with smiles wherever they are. And even Dr. Otago will be very happy to see what the kids have done to honor him on this special day. Richard, having looked at who a father is and some of the things we can do to honor our fathers, what would be your concluding thought?
I would like to encourage fathers to get closer to their children because it gives them the opportunity to open up and share the concerns they have. This reminds me of a scripture in Psalm 8 verse 4, which says, who is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him? This tells us that even though God is great, God is mighty, God is powerful, yet he still makes time for each of us and relates to each and every one of us. Michael, any other thoughts?
Yes. We want to recognize that not every father and child relationship is the way it is supposed to be. But we want to encourage everyone that God is able to restore and rebuild every broken relationship. And also in conclusion, fathers, the story of Samuel and Eli is very instructive. We find that God used Samuel, who was just a boy, to speak to Eli of things that were about to happen in the nation of Israel and Eli's family. That just goes to show that children have a lot of potential in them, deposited in them by God. Fathers, let's encourage our children. Let's nurture the gifts and talents that they have to bring out the best out of them. No wonder the Bible tells us that someone goes on to become a very great shepherd in Israel. So on this special day, we want to just encourage every father, nurture your children, bring out the best that is in them by giving them an opportunity to express what it is that they have. Richard, can you lead us in prayer as we bring our service to a close?
Okay. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for today. We thank you for all fathers and every man acting as a father figure. Lord, grant men the wisdom to raise godly children and the resources to provide for their household. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen, amen. On that note, we want to wish a happy Father's Day to Pastor
Mensa Otabel, our father in the Lord and our shepherd. Happy Father's Day
to all men in Christ Temple, ICGC Worldwide, and any man who is acting as a father. Thank you.
Thank you.
To dance with my father again.